Well, it's day six of clashes between Gaza and Israel, a death toll edging towards 90, and peace talks once again on the agenda. It's certainly been another bloody day for those living in Gaza City, at least 16 more dead in Israeli airstrikes, including a dozen civilians. And after an overnight lull, rocket fire from the Gaza Strip towards Israel has picked up again since dawn. Well, diplomatic efforts to try to end the violence in Gaza are certainly going on, despite some initial stumbles. But the UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon is expected in Cairo later this evening. He'll then start working towards trying to negotiate a peace deal. Negotiations between Hamas and Israel, brokered by Egypt, have already faltered. Ahead of his visit, Mr. Ban said, "I strongly urge the parties to cooperate with all efforts led by Egypt to reach an immediate ceasefire. Any further escalation will inevitably increase the suffering of the affected civilian populations and must be avoided." Well, Raheem Kassam is the communications director for the Henry Jackson Society with me now in the studio. Raheem, just picking up on what Ban Ki-moon was saying there, he very much sees Egypt as the conduit through which negotiations should take place. It's probably the only way, is it?
It's certainly the only way that people have suggested up until now, but I don't think it's necessarily the most legitimate way. We have to understand that Egypt has recently elected its new Muslim Brotherhood regime, its new Muslim Brotherhood government, and Muslim Brotherhood is Hamas. Hamas is the Muslim Brotherhood. They are effectively sister organizations. So to say that Egypt can be sort of a fair arbiter between the two parties, between Hamas and Israel here, is probably not something that I would advocate.
But Egypt would inevitably be pivotal to any agreement, presumably.
Well, I think so, yes. I think Egypt would have to be involved in any sort of negotiations, but I think they should be sort of broadened out to the wider international community, because it's not just Egypt who have a role to play here. I think the West has certainly a bigger role to play, countries like the United Kingdom, France, the US.
In a way, that, I mean, at the moment, we're right in the eye of the storm here, aren't we? We've got Benjamin Netanyahu saying, yes, we're ready for a ground offensive, we'll go that way if we have to. Something has to be done now, and that must involve presumably as few parties as possible if we're going to get an arrangement.
I don't actually think that's true. It's right to say that if you involve more parties, obviously negotiations will be broader, they might take slightly longer, but I actually think that both parties would be more likely to come to a decision that would be fairer on both Hamas and both Israel. Now, I say fairer to Hamas. Hamas is obviously designated as a terrorist organization here in the United Kingdom. We must view them as such. I think the real people that are suffering here are the Palestinian people who are having to live amongst rocket sites. I mean, Hamas places its rocket sites sort of 90 meters away from schools and things like that. So we need to bear those. That's the real tragedy here.
There are suggestions also that Fatah spokesmen are going to back up Hamas now, in fact, show a rare sign of unity at the moment. Without Fatah involved in one way or another, it's difficult to see any bigger picture deal done in any case. Is that something Israel should welcome, that those two start to move closer together? Even if in the early stages, it probably means they have to show support for one another.
Well, I think the reality of Fatah and the PA is that they're becoming increasingly irrelevant. People know that. People are also very aware that Israel pretty much props up the Palestinian Authority because it's in their interest to do so. Every so often we see relations between the PA and Hamas come together, and Abbas and Ismail Haniyeh sort of come up with a line together. That's not necessarily to say that they even like each other, that they want to work together, that them working together will actually produce anything real for the Palestinian people.
Okay, in just a word then, can you see a ground offensive being avoided?
I can certainly see it. I think it's going to take over the next 24 hours for anyone to really say with any confidence whether or not it's going to happen. But I think if the rocket attacks continue into Israel, then yes, Israel's ready for a ground invasion.
Raheem Kassam, thanks very much.